On Monday, Vanderhaden told TV8 News no filming would be allowed during actual testimony. He gave a number of reasons, but he objected primarily because the bright lights would bother him and the witnesses. When told we were capable of filming without lights, he still objected, saying the noise of the camera would still bother him. But the management of TV8 News decided there was no basis for the banning of our cameras since this was a public hearing being held at a public place. So this morning, we decided to film the hearing. Vanderhaden wasn't even aware we were filming until Special Agent Peter Cardoza told him that we were.
Necessary that I would want my statement to be
off the record, please. Off the record. Gentlemen, what are you taking these pictures for?
Your Honor, in all due respect, you have given us your reasons, but we feel we have a right to be here, sir, and until you give us a valid reason why we cannot, we...
This hearing will not go forward until they leave.
Good gentlemen.
Lift your foot.
Stay right here, bro.
The judge has the same authority as a federal district court judge would have to keep the media out of a courtroom during the progress of a trial.
But he's not. He has left radio reporters here, newspaper reporters here, and you can't be a television reporter without a television reporter.
Yes, but that's...
It's an important story as far as San Diegans are concerned. It is an important
I don't
story.
Care if it's Jesus Christ, get out of here.
Hold on a second. Is this fellow under arrest? Because he's not leaving unless he's under arrest.
He isn't. Check them. Call the police.
You stay right here.
Call the police.
Call the police. I think you got a demand to know when you're being arrested.
Yes, sir.
I'll ask all of the cameramen to leave here.
Sir, can you tell us why?
Because this hearing is held by a United States judge, and he does have the power and authority to order this courtroom cleared of the press and camera or anyone else. Let us clear this courtroom of the cameras.
On the record, reporter. Due to a difficulty with the press, this hearing will be continued within the hour at courtroom 6 of the United States District Court for the Southern District of California, location 945 Front Street. It is my understanding, in speaking with the clerk of that court, that U.S. Marshals have complete jurisdiction there, and when I get there, the press will be prohibited from entering the hearing room.
Does that include radio and reporters?
That includes the reporters, the members of the public. Anyone can come in that hearing room except cameras while the hearing
is on. How about tape recorders?
How about still photographers?
No still photographers.
The hearings resumed 45 minutes later at the federal courthouse, where television cameras and tape recorders are banned. When the hearings resumed, tuna fishermen and tuna boat owners expressed fear for their financial future if the porpoise kill quota remains at less than 30,000 for 1977. The hearings finally concluded tonight at 7:15, and afterward, I asked both sides if they were pleased with the developments.
Are you pleased with the way things went? Well, we do think that there was a lot of useful information provided by the fishermen, both the captains of the vessels and some of the crewmen.
Do you have any more sympathy or any less sympathy for the plight of the fishermen after this week?
Well, I think we both had great sympathy for the fishermen prior to coming here, and we still have the same concern for their situation.
But we finally today had the opportunity where the fishermen had a chance to speak up and come up with their thoughts. So I was very pleased with the way they handled themselves and at least articulated their concerns and their arguments about the proposed regulations.
The hearings now move back to Washington, D.C. and resume on Wednesday morning. By Friday, final arguments should be heard. And then, by the end of December, the fate of the future of this tuna industry should be resolved. From the federal courthouse, this is Dave Lopez reporting for TV8 News.